A push-down automata is a mathematical model that uses stack as a memory unit. So here it is again like a finite automata with extra stack as a memory unit. Finite automata doesn't have any external memory, where here we use stack as a memory unit. And each step of transition, actually it is based on a current state, one element from the input and one element from the stack. So each step of transition, it takes one element, like we use del symbol for denoting the transition. Each step of transition, it is based on current state. We'll have state and transition diagram same as that of a finite automata, and we'll take one input from the input element, one alphabet from the input element, and we'll take one element, pop out one element from the stack. You know what is stack? Stack actually it is a data structure which stores all linear datas, and always the transaction takes place in the topmost portion. When you have stack, it actually allows only two processes, push and pop. Push the elements, always pushing takes place in one direction, and when you want to remove one element, it removes the last inserted element. Okay, only this element can be removed out of the stack, and that process we call it as pop. So here each and every step of transition, it is based on current state, one element from the input, and one element will be popped out from the stack, and that will be used over here. And transaction actually moves to another state by, like, one element is popped out over here and will push some elements into stack. So each step of transition, we pop out one element and push some elements into a stack. So this is how a transition takes place in a push down automata. Sometimes push down automata allows an epsilon input too. If nothing is there in the stack, we just take it as epsilon. If nothing is there in the stack to pop out, if no element is there, we just consider it as epsilon. And sometimes we have an epsilon input too. Without any input, there might be some transactions that is possible in push down automata. Here, in order to denote the bottomness of the stack, we are going to insert, we always have one element z naught at the bottom of stack. This is a notation, like this z naught varies from the user. We are going to have one element at the stack denoting that the stack is empty. Okay, so the tuple notation over here, it consists of all the five elements from the finite automata along with the z naught. So the formal notation can be given as Q. Q is finite set of states, epsilon finite set of input symbol, del is a transition function. So each step of transition function is like this, and we have one more element called tau. This actually represents the element that can be pushed into a stack. What are the elements that can be pushed into a stack? That is denoted like this. And you have the starting state and set of all final state. Again, we have set of all final states. N number of final state is possible in push down automata too. And z naught. Totally 7 elements to represent a push down automata: finite set of states, finite set of input symbol, transition is like this, and the elements that can be pushed into a stack: q naught is the starting state, z naught is the bottom element of stack, and f is the set of all final states. So this is how a push down automata is represented. And the language representation of a push down automata is given as for any push down automata, we say that the input is accepted by a push down automata. The language is accepted by a push down automata can be denoted as, like, at the end of transition, if you have an input symbol like something, after processing all the input symbol, like your finite automata. Finite automata also accepts the input after processing all the input. Okay, so after processing all the input, we take one input at a time, we do some transition and all, and finally at the end of your input, if the transition is in final state, we have something called an accepting or final states. F is all set of final states. If this transition lies in any one of the final state, we say that the input, this input W, is accepted by the pushdown automata. This is one way of acceptance. This is similar to that of a finite automata. Sorry, language is accepted by a pushdown automata, and this is similar to a finite automata. Another way is, after processing all the input, at the end of input, if stack is empty, then we say that the finite the pushdown automata accepts the input. So this is, there are two ways in which a input can be accepted by a pushdown automata. One is, like, both are in case, like, both the acceptance depends on after processing all the input. So after processing all the input, if the transition is in final state, the input is accepted, or if the stack is empty, then we say that the input is accepted.